the baptism of Evelyn. And as we get prepared to begin, there's going to be three questions that I'm going to ask the parents. And don't worry, I'm going to give you the answers.
Okay.
And then there's going to be one question of the godparents. Okay? But to the first question, Mom is going to answer. And then to the second question, Dad is going to answer. And then to the third question, you're going to answer together. The godparents, one question, and your response is,
we are.
Okay, now even though I know Evelyn's name, that's going to be my first question. What name have you given your child?
Okay, I'll say
it. And then to the second question, you're going to say baptism. And then together to the third, you're going to say we do. Okay? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. And the Lord be with you. And on behalf of the church, I ask, what name have you given your child? And what do you ask of God's church for Evelyn?
Baptism.
You have asked then to have Evelyn baptized. In doing so, you are accepting the responsibility of training her in the practice of the faith. It will be your duty to bring her up to keep God's commandments as Christ taught us by loving God and our neighbor. So I ask you as parents, do you clearly understand what you are undertaking?
We do.
To the godparents, are you ready then to help the parents of Evelyn in their duty as Christian parents?
We are.
Evelyn, the Christian community today welcomes you with great joy, and in its name I claim you for Christ our Savior by the sign of his cross. I will now trace the cross on your forehead, and I invite your parents and godparents to do the same. I know, Evelyn, it's a rough life. And now we'll listen to this reading from Scripture taken from the Gospel of St. Mark. People were bringing their little children to Jesus to have him touch them. But the disciples were scolding them for this. Jesus became indignant when he noticed it and said to them, "Let the children come to me and do not hinder them. It is to just such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. I assure you that whoever does not accept the kingdom of God as a little child shall not enter into it." And then he embraced them and blessed them, placing his hands on them. And now the ritual of baptism calls for me to preach a homily, but you can breathe a sigh of relief. I am not, but this is a pretty good crowd. I think at least until noon. But other than to say this official word of welcome to Evelyn today, that just as the day of her physical birth was a day of rejoicing, and I'm sure for Mom in more ways than one, that today is also another day of rejoicing. The God who has given life to Evelyn, she now, through the sacrament of baptism, begins her spiritual life. With the assistance of her parents, godparents, and this extended family, and I'm sure many others in the days to come. So Evelyn, we say that word of welcome to you today. And now, my sisters and brothers, let us ask our Lord Jesus Christ to look lovingly on Evelyn, who is to be baptized, on her parents and godparents, and on all the baptized. And our response to each of these intercessions is, Lord, hear our prayer. And by the mystery of your... Mr. Binky, all right. By the mystery of your death and resurrection, bathe Evelyn in light, give her the new life of baptism, and welcome her into your holy church. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Through baptism and confirmation, make her your faithful follower and a witness to your gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lead her by a holy life to the joys of God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And make the lives of her parents and godparents examples of faith to inspire this child. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep her family always in your love, and renew the grace of our baptism in each one of us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-living God, you sent your only Son into the world to cast out the power of Satan, the spirit of evil, and to rescue us from the kingdom of darkness and bring us into the splendor of your kingdom of light. We pray today for Evelyn. Set her free from original sin. Make her a temple of your glory, and send your Holy Spirit to dwell with her. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Evelyn, we will now anoint you with the oil of salvation. In the name of Christ, who is our Savior, may he strengthen you with his power, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Okay, Evelyn, I'm going to bug you for a minute. I know, I don't blame you, but I just want to put that right there. There you go. In a moment. And now, my sisters and brothers, we ask God to give Evelyn new life and abundance through water and the Holy Spirit. To this following invocation over the water that will be used in Evelyn's baptism, I would ask that you please respond, "Blessed be God." And merciful Father, from the font of baptism, you have given us new life as your daughters and sons. And so we pray, blessed be God. And you bring together all who are baptized in water and the Holy Spirit to be one people in Jesus Christ, your Son. And so we pray, blessed be God. And you have made us free by pouring the Spirit of your love into our hearts, so that we will enjoy your peace. And so we pray, blessed be God. And you have chosen your baptized people to announce with joy the good news of Christ to all nations. And so we pray, blessed be God. And by the mystery then of this consecrated water, you bring your servant Evelyn to spiritual rebirth. You have called her to the washing of new life in the faith of your church, so that she may have eternal life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, in Evelyn's name, we are called to renounce sin and to make our own profession of faith. And so to these next six questions, if you would please respond, "I do." Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
I do.
Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And this is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. And since it is your will that Evelyn should be baptized in the faith of the Church, which we have all professed, I'd ask you to step forward to the font and remove the hat. There we go. All right, Evelyn, we're going to bug you now. Evelyn, there you are. I baptize you in the name of the Father. And of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Okay.
Pretty soon you'll need a blow dryer. Yeah. There you go.
That's good.
Ooh, Evelyn, God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ has freed you from sin and given you new birth by water and the Holy Spirit and has welcomed you into his holy people. He will now anoint you with the chrism of salvation. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so may you live always as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life. Amen. I'll be done bugging you in a minute. Evelyn, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. See in this white garment the outward sign of your Christian dignity. And with your family and friends to help you by word and example, bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting life of heaven. Amen. Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning bright. Evelyn has now been enlightened by Christ. She is to walk always as a child of the light, keeping the flame of faith alive in her heart. And when the Lord comes, may she go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. Amen. And now, once again, in Evelyn's name, we pray in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And now bow your heads as we pray for God's blessing. My sisters and brothers, I commend you all to the mercy and grace of God, our Almighty Father, of God's only Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May God protect your paths so that walking in the light of faith, you may come to the good things God has promised us. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. You survived, Evelyn. Amen. Yes. You made it. Yeah.